Moving into the world of movies at the Daytona Beach Comic Book Convention, I have Joel D. Wynkoop here with me, director, writer, creator, also comic book artist, too.
Yes, I'm delving into the... I'm not as good as Jim Fern over there, or Austin Janowski, or even Roland Mann, but I'm giving it my best shot, or John Crowther, but...
Wow.
I'm giving it my best shot. Or even George over there.
Yeah.
Awesome. I'm trying to get to his level.
And Humphrey Ching over there, too.
Yes, I'm doing what I can to become that... caliber of legend.
He's trying to get his way into Free Comic Book Day. That's what you're going for, right?
Because I want to get back and find out why Batman's now Robin and Robin has become Batman. That's not true.
But Batman's back now.
Thought I'd say that.
Well,
yeah.
Robin did become Batman for a while.
Yeah, he did in that future issue that I didn't follow.
Now, just out of curiosity, is Joel going to go to like the Batman versus Superman kind of movie? Would you actually go? Do you go to those big blockbuster kind of films, or you just avoid them?
No, absolutely. Yeah, my wife and we are going. What is it? Sunday the 25th?
Sunday, the Easter Sunday.
Yeah.
Oh, great Easter movie.
Well, I think the Lord will forgive me because he knows I'm a big Batman Superman fan. So we will be there to see Dawn of Justice. Yes, it looks awesome.
Who are you rooting for there? You know, the Bat or Kate?
I just go both because everybody's like, oh, Superman, oh, Batman. I just go Batman and Superman both rule, and they get along, and they're in the Justice League. So
and when we grew up, they were in the World's Finest. Remember?
Yeah, and World's Finest was like the equivalent to Marvel team up. The Marvel World's Finest was the DC version where everybody would team up with either Superman or Batman. And then of course Batman and Superman. But this is gonna be cool. And then you know, at the end they might be doing all this fighting, but it's gonna end with the old handshake and call me if you need me. I'll be in my cave.
I like that.
Right, Batman, I don't know.
Was that Wonder Woman?
No, that was Wonder Woman.
Okay.
And plus she smokes a lot in this show.
It's Lucy as Wonder Woman.
Yeah. She's like, Batman, Superman, follow me. Who was that? That was Wonder Woman.
Instead of, Ricky, it'll be, Steve, where are you, Steve? Yeah.
I'm looking for Steve Trevor.
Where are you?
So, I want to have his babies. Okay, enough of that. Sorry.
Okay. The wild man here. And of course, are you going to get into the Captain America Civil War thing, or is that just too dark?
Oh, I've already been into the Civil War thing. Don't get me started. I can tell you the entire Civil War rundown from all the books.
Well,
so this in the Civil War movie, Captain America 3 Civil War, they'll never hardly even touch what they did in the books. So the Nova coming back from the Annihilation World, coming back to, and Nova he's still a youngster basically, and he's yelling at Captain America saying, what are you guys doing? And Captain America's, we're fighting over our freedom of our secret identities. And Nova's like, you guys are fighting over your secret identity. Basically Nova was going, you guys are a bunch of morons, and you've been at this a lot longer than I have. I've only started in the late 70s meeting Spider-Man, and I know better than all of you guys. I mean, and because here in the movie you've only got Cap and Falcon and Black Panther, right, and Spidey and Iron Man and Ant-Man and somebody else, I think, and fighting against each other. But in the comics it was everybody. It was the X-Men, it was Fantastic Four, it was everybody. Spidey,
Daredevil,
everybody.
Gets locked up in the jail.
Yep. Spidey was working with Iron Man first, I believe.
Yeah. Yes.
And then he went over to Cap's side because he just thought, he goes, I don't know if this is right or not.
And the Punisher goes off on his own kind of a little bit.
Yeah, Punisher was doing his own thing. Yeah. He wasn't really involved with them as much. But for them to do it, the budgets are always gigantic now. Yeah. They would be oversized. But looking forward to that too. It's still going to be cool. And especially when the trailer, when Spidey fires down his web and he yanks up Cap's shield. And Iron Man goes, Underoos? And he fires it down and he pulls it up and goes, hey, everybody.
You're thinking Steve Ditko there with the art probably a little bit.
Ditko stuff is awesome. Yeah, from way back in the day, yeah.
Now, I'm recommending that people who are unfamiliar with Civil War, especially have little kids, read Civil War, go to your comic book store, get it, because I think there's going to be a little shock with the ending we're not going to spoil here. I think they think it's going to be a fun, fighting kind of movie, but they're going to be shocked.
Yeah, I believe that, and I don't know the ending because I'm not seeing any secret premieres or whatever. So I just know how it ended in the books. They just destroyed New York. In fact, Captain America was saying to some people, were yelling, stop, and Captain America was like, we're trying to protect you. And the citizen yelled back and he goes, protect us from what? Protect us from you. And then Captain America looked around and the buildings are all crashing down on the ground and it's all their fault. And that's when he just turned around and he goes, Avengers, stand down. And Spidey and everybody just stopped and put their hands out and said, arrest us. Because he knew he's basically tearing up the city and making a war and right in the middle of the city, and Cap did the right thing. He just gave himself up, and everybody gave up.
Now
they moved past Civil War, and they went on to something else, the Annihilation Factor.
that's not the whole movie. Trust me, right there. But Joel, yeah. Before I let you go here,
okay.
Because I know you got to get to dealing with some fans and stuff.
No, I don't. I have no fans.
Yes, he does.
Everybody
he
hates me. People are coming by throwing Pepsi cans at me.
No.
They're like, is that Wynkoop? And then Pepsi cans,
no.
Cobs of corn. One of them came and it had corn on it. I was like, oh man, I told my wife, I'm starved. We didn't get any lunch here today. Tom Rob's Cheapskate. He didn't give me a damn thing to eat.
That promoter.
So I was like, yeah, I know it. So I was eating the corn. I was like, Tom, you got some butter? And he was like, Wynkoop, why don't you just shut your mouth and be happy I got you here? And
I was
like,
complaints
all right,
about,
I know.
I have complaints about him too. Let's complain.
Yeah, he's just annoying.
Yeah, he is.
Walks around. He's got this Hitler mentality.
And
people come up to him and they go, hey, Tom, did you get my space? Shut
leave
up.
Me alone.
You
me
take
alone.
That little box. You sleep in a box in the street and that's where you set your comic books up at. And the guy, remember the guy down there?
Yes.
Usher Johnson. Yep. He's got a cardboard box. It's way over there, Kimmy. You can't see it even if
way
you use your
there.
Zoom. It's so far. It's a cardboard, trust me, it's a cardboard box. The guy's sitting inside the cardboard box with some corn chips and a bottle of water that Tom gave me. He goes, you have corn chips, a bottle of water, and try and sell that comic. And if you give you any more crap, I'll kick you in the teeth. No, Tom was trying to do this. He was like, kick you in the teeth.
I know.
He's trying to do. I know.
He's
evil. Tom Rop is evil.
Evil promoter. Evil promoter.
Yes. It's like Dr. Doom, and Dr. Octopus, and Lex Luthor.
And Red Skull.
And Red Skull.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like Red Tom Rop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch out for him.
He will kill you.
Watch out, Daytona.
Yeah. It's just like you're walking up there. Tom Rop, how's it going? Bam! That's how it's going. Get out of my face. I'm Tom Rop and I rule. Bam, bam!
Exactly.
Bonk, bonk on the head.
Well, Joel, I'm going to let you get back to your non-fans here.
None of them hate me.
Before I let you go, how many movies have you done, either directed, written, or starred in?
I've done a little over 120 movies. And they're released all over the country and all over the world, and my voice is dubbed in a whole bunch of languages I don't even know. I watched Killing Spree in Italian the other night, and I go, I don't know what I'm saying, but it's kind of cool.
Whoa. So you're like the John Carradine, because I remember his filmography is like 200 films.
That was actually an article. There's a guy in the paper. What's that guy in the Tampa Times? What's his name? He's going to kill me now. You're going to show him this video, and he's going to be, can't even remember my
you
name.
You remember me.
But he said Carradine of... Yeah, Christopher Lee. Yeah, he said he called me the Christopher Lee of independent B movies or something. Yeah, so kind of in that Carradine level and all back in the 50s and everything.
So
that's kind of neat.
If you love horror films and you love to talk about comic books and horror films and all those kind of things, see him, Joel D. Wynkoop. Where will you be next?
Because at least four people like my movies. At least four people. And only two people have seen Truth or Dare, but at least four people have seen the rest of my movies.
Our goal is to make it five. Five.
Five. I need one more person to just, if we had a like meter on this like they do on like on Talking Dead and they go right in and see what this is and it'll the levels of what we should have that on here, but Kimmy's gonna get on that next time.
Five
for a level to get five. I need five fans.
Five.
Because I've got four fans at home. They all got those plugs, but none of them work.
Are they relatives?
The one. Yeah, they're the fans that you plug in and you turn the little switch on. Yeah, there's a big fan, a little fan. I got a round one and a square one.
Where will you be next?
Now I'll be back here in November. And then also FusionCon just wrote me and they would like me to come back in September. And I'm talking to Scott still, I think, about Claremont.
Claremont Con, yes.
And other than that, I don't know. I don't know. I haven't heard from anybody else that says, hey, come on out here.
We'll put a link to your stuff on our website at RileyandKimmy.com. Thank you for being on the show.
JoelDWynkoop.com.
Joel, can I offer
and
you?
Kimmy and I did the contest, too.
Yes, they did the cosplay contest together.
Yeah.
And I'm offering, if you can come on the show on an extended, maybe we can talk about movies and all kinds of things.
That would be cool. That would be absolutely amazing.